I would like to create a stem and leaf plot off of the heart rate data I've been working with in my previous video examples. And instead of doing a stem and leaf plot by hand, which is not difficult to do, but if you have a large data set, it can be cumbersome. Instead, I want to do the stem and leaf plot by using Minitab Express. Now, looking at what the values the data takes on, just scrolling through my column of data, it appears that a good choice for the stems would be the tens place and the leaves to be the units place. And again, it's helpful if the data is put in order if you wanted to do this by hand. But to do this in Minitab Express, I want to click on graphs, the same place that we went to in my previous example to get the histogram. And you'll see here that this option right underneath the graphs tab is the stem and leaf plot. Now it says here that it works best when the sample size is less than 50. Well, it works reasonably well if your data set is over 50, but I think at about 80 to 100 values, perhaps a histogram would be a better choice. The advantage to a stem and leaf plot over a frequency distribution is that the values that the data take on, or the data set, those values aren't lost in the graph. So you can easily look at the stem and leaf plot and tell what the actual data set is. In a frequency distribution, the data set is converted over to counts. So you lose a little bit of resolution, particularly with respect to things like the mean and standard deviation, which will be discussed a little further in the course. All right, so I want to click on stem and leaf plot. And again, I want to select the column that has my data, and I only have one column of data. So I can double click that, and it moves that title of the column over to the variable field. And I'm gonna leave everything else alone. If I had a second column, if I were grouping, let's say I had another column that indicated gender, I could group by gender and do a split stem and leaf plot. So I'm going to leave that blank because I don't have another variable to sort by. All right, so I'm going to click on OK. And the stem and leaf plot will be in the display pane. And so going back to my home tab, I just want to see the output only. Now there's a couple of things to notice about the stem and leaf plot output in Minitab. This middle column is actually the stems. The values on the right, and notice they are put in order, are the leaves. So I can look at the stem and leaf plot and know that my minimum value was 62. So I can reconstruct the data set just by looking at the stem and leaf plot. So I have a 62, a 65, a 67, a 68, and so on, all the way up to my maximum value of 98. So if you were to draw this by hand, it's kind of nice to draw a vertical line down in between the stem and the leaves. Minitab does something interesting. This first column of numbers is how many data points cumulatively there are up until the row that contains the median. Now, at this point, we haven't talked about what the median is. The median is a measure of central tendency. It also happens to be a measure of position. The median value of a data set that's put in order separates the lower 50% of the values from the upper 50%. So this 20 in the parentheses indicates to me, the parentheses indicates that the median is actually somewhere in this row. And we can find the median very easily using Minitab Express. And I'll save that for a different video example. So going back to this first value, this one means that I have one value cumulatively up to this point. So you can think of it as a running total. So for the second row, I've got four values here plus the one previously. So I cumulatively, I have five values. And then looking down, I have six values in this row plus the five previously. So I have 11, and then so on. So it takes how many values have occurred already and then adds it to how many values are in that current row up to the row before the row that contains the median. Now this row by itself contains 20 values, and in this row the median will be placed. All right, so looking after the row that contains the median, you can think of it as cumulatively working from the bottom up. So this row here where the stem is 9 and the leaf is 8, so I know there's a value of 98 in my original data set, has one value in this row. And then you'll see the row above it has three values, so 3 plus 1 is 4. And then the next row has five values, so 5 plus 4 is 9. So it reads cumulatively in terms of counts from the largest value down to the row right after the row that contains the median. Now, when you're constructing a stem and leaf plot by hand, you don't need this first row. It's just something that's included in the Minitab Express output. What you need to be more concerned with is the column that contains the stem and right after the stems, all of the rows that contain the leaves. If you want to cut and paste a stem and leaf plot into a document, you can just click on the stem and leaf plot. Notice that it will put a rectangular boundary around it, and right click, and then you can copy, and then you can paste it into whatever document you need a stem and leaf plot.